All right. So our study examined content in the form of news on the social network like Twitter, and we specifically looked at how the virality of that information affected the perceived credibility of the content itself. So the foundation for our study was built on the theory of gate watching, which suggests that the public is no longer simply just a recipient of the news, but that they play an active role in both the shaping, reporting, and then more importantly, the spread of news. So we thought that this research was important for two reasons. The first is that roughly half of Twitter users get their news from the site. And during that study, which was in 2014, there were about 66 million active accounts in the United States. The second reason is that 46% of college students are using Twitter as one of their primary sources for news, and they're using it on almost a daily basis. And that works out to about 10 million people.
So for our study, we looked at a post-test-only control group design. And what we were looking for was whether credibility was affected by the number of retweets that information received. So we had 109 undergraduate students, and basically it was another convenient sample with our SDSU population here. They were assigned to one of three treatment groups. One was a high retweet group. That's so hard to say. The second being the low retweet group, and then one control group. So our stimuli, what we had for the first group, the low retweet group, was basically five different tweets from authentic sources, news sources. And basically what we manipulated in that was the number of retweets was artificially between 10 and 20. Our second one, the high retweet group, was basically the same, five retweets, but the number of retweets was between 1,000 and 1,500, so quite a bit different. And then our control group, they all received the same five retweets, but the source information and the number of retweets was eliminated from those five tweets. And so basically after they saw that information, they went through a scale that basically looked at the six different items that assess the credibility of the information that they received in the tweets. So the range was whether they agreed strongly or disagreed strongly based on the credibility that they thought that information rated. We also had one manipulation check, which was basically to see if they could tell based on the number of retweets a regular tweet received, whether they could tell the difference between high and low.
Okay, so for those manipulation checks, we found that the participants weren't able to tell how many retweets their tweets had. So the high viral group could tell that there were thousands of retweets, and the control group knew that there weren't any. So that means that any differences between the cells, it's most likely not due to chance, that there's actually, the independent variable actually had an effect. So then Kendra mentioned the credibility scale. So we created an index from that credibility scale. So there were six different nominal variables, and we found the means for each of those variables, as well as a combined mean out of 30 possible points. And then we did a reliability analysis to see if our scale was consistent or not. So we found that it was reliable. There were consistent answers between each of the different nominal variables. So for the three different cells, the mean for the high viral group was about 22.5. For the low viral group, it was 23.2. And for the control group, it was 19.7. So then we compared those scores using an ANOVA, and then we found that there were statistically significant differences between the low viral group and the control group and the high viral group and the control group, but there was no significant differences between the low viral and the high viral groups.
Just kind of recapping where we all started here, our study began with the research question of how the virality, a little bit of a made-up word, but how the virality of online news content impacts the perceived credibility of information. And then from that research question, we had a hypothesis of the fact that we actually proposed that the credibility of information distributed through social media is going to increase with the virality of the information. And then kind of a additional point, so further that a retweet from an unofficial source from an official source with high virality would be perceived as significantly more credible than a tweet from an official source with low virality. So, mouthful. Hopefully everybody got it. If not, we'll cover it again at the end. And And then to answer the research question, test the hypothesis, we compared the Twitter messages with numbers of retweets ranging from 0 to 1,500, as we covered earlier. And then what we're able to conclude from that is that perceived credibility did in fact relate to the fact that a message had been retweeted, the actual number of retweets, but was not or did not relate to the specific number of retweets. So it did relate to the fact that it had been retweeted, but not to the number specifically of retweets. And then we actually confirmed that looking at the low retweet, what we call experimental cells, looking at the group with low retweets versus the group with higher retweets. And then what we found comparing those two is that there were not significant differences in perceived credibility. So differences, yes, but not enough to really make a meaningful conclusion looking at the differences. And then this was consistent with some previous research that found that perceived credibility of tweets is actually influenced by what's called Twitter user endorsement, which again looks at the fact that messages, you know, Twitter messages have been retweeted regardless of the number of retweets. And then another aspect of our study looked at what's called gate watching, which suggested that social media allows users to actively participate in shaping the information environment because the user can actually select which messages are perceived as relevant enough to reach them. So the user in social media has some control. And then next we looked at some limitations of what we found in our results. So specifically what we call the generalizability, another mouthful there, but basically it's just the ability of the results to be applied to a greater population. So in this case, it'd be the population of all Twitter users, since obviously we didn't look at everyone on Earth that uses Twitter. We had to look at a sample, and then there were some limitations with applying what we found in our sample to the greater population of all Twitter users. And the limitations were due to kind of what we call the convenient nature. I know we brought that up before here, but the convenient nature of our sample in our experiment. And it has to do with the fact that our sample specifically looked at the undergraduate students at SDSU that were enrolled in the Department of Journalism and Media Studies. So kind of some limitations with the diversity of the sample from that specific group. But, you know, for us, it was the most feasible sample we could use by the time we were given. So it just introduced some limitations. And then, as Kendra mentioned, also the number of participants was another issue with limitations, since relatively small, right? We had 109 users, even though more than, or 109 participants in our experiment, even though more than 500 were actually invited to participate, but that's just kind of the nature of the response rate. Sometimes you get a lot, sometimes you get a little. And then the kind of the bottom line with all this stuff is that the generalizability of our results is somewhat limited, since including a more diverse sample and a greater number within the sample could possibly cause our results to be different. So just some limitations there. And then trying to connect to actual public relations, the results actually suggest that organizations could increase the perceived credibility of their tweets by encouraging their social media followers to retweet what they post on Twitter. So that would have an effect there on the perceived credibility. And then in closing, we also considered some recommendations for additional research in the future, which we felt needs to be done to determine if the findings would be different if you actually looked at tweets from unofficial sources and considered that in your samples. We just looked at the official sources with high and low retweets, and then look at also the impact that would have on perceived credibility. And also, future studies could kind of take a look at the different elements of a tweet, you know, whether or not a long tweet compared to a short tweet, which obviously, by definition, tweets are short, but you know, relatively speaking, long tweet versus a short tweet, would be effective on perceived credibility. You know, if you made it a little more wordy, would that lend you more credibility? And then looking at whether or not a tweet actually included a hyperlink to the source material, you know, just kind of some different elements that might affect your perceived credibility. So that kind of wraps up what we looked at and the results from our survey. So I think we'll open it up to Q&A if anyone has any questions.